I don't know if this should be part of it, but I guess you will cut and just.
So Payday 3 is launching with 8 unique heists, and our goal is essentially to ensure that each heist has its own identity. So when the creative process starts, we're always asking ourselves, what unique gameplay element does this heist have? And how do we make it look and feel unique, even if some of them have a similar setting? So we're really trying to make each heist feel like a set piece. But most importantly, we're making them feel Payday.
Two of the hardest things to get people to coordinate is positioning and movement. And stealth at its core is positioning and movement. I'm Per, and I'm a design lead here at Starbase. We're trying to make it less binary, so we have soft fails, so we have different security levels in different areas. Like if you get caught trespassing in certain areas, you don't get cuffed, you get escorted out and you can try again. You can make a mistake and not go loud immediately.
Like if you break stealth, we don't want that to feel like a failure. We want that to just feel like, oh, okay, well now we're going with the other plan or the other play style. And that's reflected in a lot of things, like the skills and the gadgets and, you know, how the civilians work as well.
So creating a co-op stealth game as opposed to something that is solo only, a big difference there is players can do a lot of different things in parallel, right? Like there is not really one linear path, and you know, different players can essentially go to different locations and do their thing if that's the way you want to play. Every time we design a heist in stealth, we have to think about all the different layers tied to that and different options that players can do, and also make sure that they feel incentivized to do them.
We have expanded the masked off stealth experience, and so you can do a lot of objectives and a lot of work in stealth without putting your mask on.
Example, maybe not everybody wants to mask up during stealth. Maybe two players will mask up and two will stay encasing, but even those players encasing can help. So that way, if you're not confident in what you're about to do and don't want to risk going loud, you can maybe play it a bit more safe and do the less risky things that still need to be done.
One way we've been doing to modernize sort of the interactions and mechanics that you're doing is there are less quick interactions. It's more about bypassing obstacles by managing hostages, moving them around. There's a lot about movement and just general coordination between players, and also using the tools that you have.
We've expanded a lot on the civilians in stealth. So we've broken down civilians into your regular Joe Schmoes and the employees, and they care about different things. Civilians have more value. So in Payday 2, you just kind of traded them to get people out of custody. We still have that, but we also have the negotiation phase. Enemies care about whether there's any civilians nearby or not. Shotgun enemies, they will switch to a more precise weapon. We have a new enemy as well, the threat of gas grenades, but they will resort to using flashbangs if there are also civilians in the area. We also have some skills that leverage and give you more stuff if you trade civilians, so they have a value outside of just getting somebody out of custody. There's a lot of strategy involved in where you place a civilian, so you might not want to trade all civilians right away, but of course there's always the risk that you might kill them because they're in the way of fire.
So we have security modifiers in Payday 3, which essentially is a way for us to sort of throw in a wrench into the game when you're stealthing. Depending on what difficulty you play, we have a rotation of security firms, and what they do is they change how you have to approach different things. It's a way to make the heist more challenging and also increasing replayability.
I would say for stealth, we also tried to make objectives and goals scale a bit with the number of players, not in a more like if you're solo, you have less stuff to do, you have the same amount to do. For example, in one heist, you might need to do a hacking objective on one end, but then you need to go and do something on the other end of the heist, and then that's something another player can do.
So the world has evolved since Payday 2, and that's something that we've adapted to as well. So you will see more security systems, and you will see more tools and equipment that are high tech. Also in general, the world feels a little bit more high-tech, but it's still contemporary. And making sure that it feels contemporary has also been an important part of the vision, since the game is going to grow over time. And we want to make sure that it feels sort of timeless in that sense.
From my point of view, a lot of the more digital stuff is in the gadgets. I feel also the hacking is a bit more expanded, and we have a foundation there to further expand at post-launch. So right now, hacking is mostly focused, or the systemic, non-objective hacking in the game is more focused on cameras. We have certain plans for down the line to further expand hacking functionality as we add more content in the game.
So there are a bunch of new gadgets in Payday 3 when it comes to stealth. What we have focused on primarily is the goal has been to increase the player agency, meaning gadgets should be a tool for you to sort of either de-escalate situations or different ways of approaching security systems or infiltrating the locations that you're supposed to heist.
So as far as voice lines go, we have something that we internally call coordinated voice lines, which is SWATs will react to things in the world and say a line, and sometimes that stuff is related to other enemies. So if there is a dozer somewhere nearby, you'll hear a SWAT say, make way for the dozer or clear the way for the dozer. That's also a hint to the players. There's a dozer nearby, and they will have some lines for civilians as well.
We have a bunch of new puzzle mechanics, especially during stealth, because stealth is when you usually have to be pretty calm and very strategic in terms of what you're doing to not escalate the map. Some of our maps also have very unique security systems. So, you know, there are laser grids, alarm floors, sensors that are moving. So we're definitely evolving the type of obstacles that you have to bypass in Payday 3.
The difficulty of stealth varies quite a bit from map to map, but it also, your approach has to change between maps. So you need to adapt to the heist quite a bit. It's less of a racing game. What's and more, goal? It requires a bit more patience to figure out what happens and how to move around.
Coordination is also really important for the difficulty of a heist, and not just you know, coordinating who's where and who's doing what, but coordinating skills is also very important.
When you heist in Payday 3, I love the fact that you many times feel that you are in control and things are going pretty well. And then you open the vault and you start stealing money. And you realize, holy shit, there's a lot of money here. Let's steal some more. That's usually when you get really, really fucked. That was pretty good, no?
They use radios. It still says pagers in a few places, but it shouldn't.
And then understanding... Oh, yeah, what the fuck?
I did not confirm or deny it.
Nej! Jag tror att det är ett fett sätt att avsluta New York på.